Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Prestige, and we are back on Black Ops 3 because I want to talk about a brand new community challenge that's coming out on May 12th. This community challenge will be available for zombies and multiplayer, and it's going to require us to work as a community to earn those headshots. This specific challenge is unique in the fact that it's celebrating the Zombies Chronicles, and that reflects directly in the calling cards and the camouflage that we can earn. So let's take a look at our rewards. Tier number one, we're going to get a Richtofen and Takio calling card. Tier number two, we're going to get a Nikolai and Dempsey calling card. Tier three will give us an animated calling card with all four of our heroes. And tier four will allow us to unlock a pack-a-punch camouflage for every single weapon in the game. Now, as of right now, we don't know how many headshots it's going to take to actually earn each reward, but with zombies being included, the number may be high, but we can definitely achieve our goal. I know for sure. Now, originally, this artwork was first revealed by Treyarch over on their Twitter page. They kept changing their Twitter header every single day to a different character. As soon as that first piece of artwork went up, I knew immediately. I was like, this looks like something straight out of Metal Gear Solid, and that to me just stuck every single day when they kept changing it to Richtofen, Takio, Dempsey. Every single day they kept changing it. And then finally, it was formally announced as of yesterday that Yoji Shinkawa was actually the person behind this artwork. And to me, I love the Metal Gear Solid series, I love the Call of Duty series, and to bring those two together in the form of artwork, and to be able to represent this artwork in-game, to me, that's a huge honor. Like, being able to do that, that is just a huge freaking honor. I've been a fan of the Metal Gear series ever since I've been, like, 5 years old, which is ridiculous, but it's crazy to think about how much things can change over the years, and I'm really, really hoping that this opens up a new partnership with Yoji Shinkawa and, of course, Activision, Treyarch, Sledgehammer, whoever else moving forward, and he can create unique styles of artwork like this. I can tell you right now, it probably wasn't cheap to get the rights to use this in-game, but oh my god, thank you, Treyarch. That is so cool. It's important to note that this is the beginning of something called 8 Days of the Undead, a new celebration that Treyarch is throwing out there in which we'll be able to do community challenges, unlock exclusive pieces of gear, and of course, even have double XP. 8 different zombie maps are being recreated for the Zombies Chronicles, so that means 8 Days of the Undead, and I think that it lines up pretty well, so it's gonna be nice to see just exactly what else we'll be able to unlock during this time, but it's nice to know that we're going to have this special community challenge once again to be able to complete and of course unlock those amazing calling cards by Yoji Shinkawa. I also appreciate that this isn't just a zombies thing as well, so if you are a multiplayer person and you don't necessarily like playing zombies all the time, you don't have to. All of your headshots that you get in multiplayer will count as well, and that's a really nice thing that I just wanted to point out. I figured we could also take this time to talk about the different types of gobblegum that are coming as well. All of these gobblegums will be available for every single person, regardless if you have the Zombies Chronicles or not. The only gobblegum that won't be available are the 2 whimsical gobblegums, which don't actually give you an advantage over anybody. It's just something fun and different that you can use if you wanted to lighten up your game a little bit. So, first things first, we have a Mega Gobblegum called Board Games. It will last 5 rounds, repairing 1 board at a window where we repair all the boards at a window. Next up, we have Flavor Hexed. This is also a Mega Gobblegum. It will immediately activate. Selects a random Mega, Rare, or Ultra Gobblegum that is not in the player's loadout. If the player doesn't bleed or take a new Gobblegum from the machine, this will repeat a second time when the first has run out. That's kind of interesting. Next up, we have Bored to Death. This is a Rare Gobblegum. It will last 5 minutes. Zombies within 15 feet of a repaired board are killed. Next up, we have Extra Credit. This is also Rare. 4 activations available, spawns a personal point power-up worth 1,250 points. That to me is pretty crazy, especially on maps that require points for you to have to do an Easter egg. If you guys didn't know, Gobblegum will be free for your very first purchase. Instead of actually counting for 500 points in the beginning, your very first time buying Gobblegum, it will be free. If you end up getting that specific gumball, my goodness, you're going to start off the game with 5,000 points. That's actually a pretty good advantage. All right, next up we have Idle Eyes. This is a Rare Gobblegum as well. 3 activations lasting 30 seconds each. All zombies ignore all players and stand idle. That could actually be really good for the Moon Easter egg. Next up, we have Soda Fountain. 5 activations when purchasing a perk. Perk purchase limit is ignored when purchasing a perk. Get a random one for free. Holy crap, that seems a little overpowered. Next up, we have Power Vacuum. This is an Ultra Gobblegum. It will last for 4 full rounds. Power-ups drop more often. Okay, that's pretty cool. Next up, we have Raindrops. This is an Ultra Gobblegum. 2 activations. It will spawn 1 of each of the 9 core power-ups when activated. You'll drop a nuke, double points, fire sale, insta-kill, random perk, max ammo, death machine, and blood money power-up. What the hell? That is a little bit OP as well, but those are the Gobblegums that are going to be available for everybody. The last 2 are the Whimsical. This will only be available with the Zombies Chronicles. So first off, we have Eye Candy. This is a Whimsical. 4 activations. It will override the colors you see. It'll create a color overlay that will highlight zombies in a color that can change by reactivating Gobblegum. That sounds pretty cool. And finally, we have Tone Death. This will activate after a certain amount of zombie kills, and it will basically play a set of silly, random zombie sounds and death sounds instead of the normal ones. So I really can't wait to see what that means. But anyway, guys, that is going to conclude today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. Click that notification button to stay up to date on when I upload. And until tomorrow, my friends, I will see ya. Peace.